Find out how the creme de la creme of Korean culture is being made known to the world, from the Korean language to traditional customs and beautiful settings. This September is a month filled with multilateral forums and summit talks for Korea. Learn about Korea's evolving role amidst the shifting international dynamics of today. The convergence of traditional cultural resources with science and technology is emerging as a new growth engine to lead the culture industry. September 9th is Organ Donation Day in Korea. We look into the necessity of organ donations and how they should be encouraged.
Korean culture is spreading throughout the world. It is growing as a culture for the global community, one which can be shared by all as a channel of communication. Accordingly, culture communication experts from around the world have gathered in Seoul. The Culture Communication Forum was held on September 6th at a hotel in Seoul. Launched in 2010, the Culture Communication Forum is in its seventh year. It invites leaders from the world's cultural superpowers to introduce and discuss Korea's cultural hotspots. Korea was represented by ballerina Kang Soo-jin.
So also, we have to be also careful in the art, anything. How much body can collect? Very body.
아시아에서 한국이 문화적으로는 좀 리더 역할을 할 수 있을 것 같았어요. 그래서 저희가 아시아 나라이긴 하지만은 세계의 문화소통계 리더들을 초청해서 한국 문화의 정수를 보여주고 또 그들의 다른 문화들을 우리가 또 알 수 있는 기회를 가짐으로써 문화소통을 통해서 하나의 연결을 이루고 그것도 연결됨으로써 정말 어떻게 보면 문화융성이 이루어지는 거 아니겠어요? 그래서 그러한 취지로 저희가 생각을 했었습니다.
Delegates who came to Korea toured Changdeokgung Palace, the National Museum of Korea, and a hands-on hanbok event experiencing Korea's culture firsthand. Changdeokgung Palace is a Joseon period palace, an important cultural asset which offers a fresh glimpse into Korean concepts of space.
It's the first time I come here, and it's amazing to see this kind of monument in this area. It's gorgeous.
The Loyal Garden in particular is a masterpiece, one of the reasons why Changdeokgung Palace is so popular among foreign visitors.
I love the preservation of these very traditional temples in the middle of the city, having that proximity to that quite traditional culture next to a very contemporary city is very exciting.
I love to travel and to compare different ways of life and concepts of living. So I think it's very important to understand how Koreans live.
On the second day, the visitors tried on hanbok, one of the top activities foreign tourists in Korea look forward to. The participants wore hanbok as they viewed the traditional wooden furniture in an old-fashioned hanok home.
If you come on your own, you don't really get to see, experience, and understand. And this particular location is quite amazing. Yeah? The aesthetic, the detail, you could see there was a very sophisticated thought historically, in a very refined, you know, very refined order of society. It is really very impressive.
One can't truly experience Korea without trying the food. On the menu for lunch was white wine and sparkling wine made from omija berries, and diners heard stories about the native fruit. It was an opportunity to feel Korea's charms and flavors through the senses of taste and sight. Tasting Korean food led to an appreciation of the clean, full flavors of the cuisine and a greater affection for Korean culture as a whole.
This group is very mixed, all kinds of people from different countries and different professions. Some are museum people like me, some are business people, some are food people, some are performance people. I think we can probably have quite a fruitful time in a few short days. We can do some interesting things.
The Culture Forum, attended by cultural leaders from all over the world, came to an end with a session of traditional Korean music and a discussion on the importance of connections to strengthen cultural communication. How did the expats define cultural communication?
I think culture is definitely a long-term investment. You may not understand immediately the result or the purpose, but I think it's like a seeding, you know. I'm a farmer, so in my business, so I know and I'm used to wait. And I think this is a seeding of understanding, of leadership, of taste, of creativity. So I think it's useful, yes.
An opportunity to stand back and take perspective, to be able to listen, to learn, to be open-minded, and within the norm of our daily routines, this isn't possible. But within this program and this forum, that opportunity is created so that you understand, you receive, you're able to contribute and reflect, which is, it's a luxury in modern society.
Cultural leaders of diverse nationalities had a chance to experience Korea firsthand with all of their senses. Through them, we hope that Korea's culture will spread even further to all corners of the globe.
From the Eastern Economic Forum in Russia and the G20 Summit in China to the ASEAN Summit in Laos, September has been packed with high-profile multilateral forums and summits. How will these developments influence international politics, and what will be Korea's role and challenges? President Park's 8-day-long diplomatic tour has commenced. Its start was the second Eastern Economic Forum in Russia. The theme of the forum was opening up the Far East. President Park delivered a keynote address and held a summit with a Russian leader, seizing the opportunity to reaffirm the strategic partnership between Korea and Russia.
Russia being a little bit of a distance away, probably concern is there, but not as severe as China, and certainly not as immediate as the Korean situation. So I think that's the reason that the THAAD issue was not even surfaced in the closing remark or joint statement. Instead, the focus on the economic issues, which is a common interest both for Korea and also in Russia because of the deteriorating situation there, I think it's a beneficial subject matter to focus on for both countries.
After Russia, the next leg of President Park's diplomatic tour took her to the G20 summit in China, and then concluded with the ASEAN summit in Laos. These back-to-back multilateral forums also gave the leaders of the participating nations a chance to hold bilateral summits as well. During the G20 summit, President Park held a summit with the Chinese president as well. The summit was a chance to repair diplomatic ties after the controversial THAAD decision, in line with the strategy of active diplomacy in response to the North Korean nuclear issue.
Superficially, United Nations Security Council is united on the issue of sanctioning North Korea, showing that North Korea must stop developing further nuclear weapons and also further launching of ballistic missiles in the future, something like that. So I think the international community has created a new front line to tackle North Korean issues. So it is very important, this kind of multilateral summit is cementing the way for further cooperation on curbing North Korean provocations in the international community.
The U.S. and China also held a summit on the sidelines of the G20 summit after a period of tensions brought on by the South China Sea conflicts and THAAD deployment.
They were actually, you know, nervous about the security issues, especially in Northeast Asian region, like, you know, South China Sea dispute and East China Sea issues, something like that. Especially on the issue of a THAAD deployment, you know, they showed a rift on the deployment issues on the Korean Peninsula. As you see on the economic issues, you know, China is strongly committed to expanding their free trade issues in the future to further grow their economies in the future.
China and U.S., I think this time around they had a pretty substantial talk lasting about 4 hours, and they clashed in many different subject matters. I think the background is that the pivot to Asia policy that U.S. has clashes in many ways with China's enlarging influence in the region. The subject matter certainly included the THAAD and also human rights and also issues about the South China Sea and East China Sea.
Finally, in Laos, where the ASEAN summit was held, President Park went all out in multilateral diplomacy. The 18th Korea-ASEAN summit, 19th ASEAN Plus 3 summit, and the 11th East Asia summit were all held in Laos. Every participating state, including Korea, explored ways to enhance ASEAN partnership as well as multilateral cooperation.
South Korean government is emphasizing our middle power diplomacy so much. And the ASEAN countries are ideal target for South Korea's middle power diplomacy. By definition, the middle power diplomacy is to providing regional common good. In that regard, Korea's ODA to Southeast Asian countries, Korea's cooperation in the field of non-traditional and human security with the ASEAN countries, they are a very good item for South Korean middle power diplomacy.
From Russia to China and Laos, all eyes were on the high-profile multilateral forums this September. President Park used this opportunity to advance her diplomatic strategy against North Korean nuclear proliferation and successfully drew international interest to the issue.
Korea's traditional cultural resources are combining with cutting-edge technology to re-emerge as a high-added value industry. Through science and tech, traditional cultural resources are being reborn as fascinating contents and products with global appeal. The Rio Olympic Games were a resounding success. During the Games, one performance captivated the attention of visitors to Rio from all over the world. It was the hologram performance, Chansangmudo, or Heavenly Dance. Chansangmudo is a performance which reinterprets famous artworks from Korea's history through hologram technology. Combining Korea's historical traditions and modern technology, the performance was lauded by visitors.
최근에 이제 모션 그래픽이나 홀로그램과 같은 문화 기술이 접목되는 추세를 제가 좀 반영해서 기획하게 되었습니다. 한국의 대서사시라는 전통과 현대 융복합 대서사시라는 주제를 가지고요. 무대와 관객 사이에 어떤 투명 막을 설치하기도 하고요. 스크린을 두 개를 사용해서 공간각적인 공간을 만드는 그런 것들이 새로운 시도고요. 홀로그램을 통한 전통을 융복합하는 공연은 아마 제가 알기로는 한국에서는 아마 최초로 시도된 공연이라고 알고 있습니다.
Virtual reality is cited as a next generation growth engine. VR startup Gordon Media is carrying out what it calls a K-View project to publicize Korea's traditional cultures through VR. Gordon Media is upping the pace on developing content that encompasses tourism, education, and culture based on traditional arts and artifacts.
K-View 프로젝트는 극사실적인 그래픽 구현, 가상현실 구현 기술을 바탕으로 한국의 문화 예술 또한 역사를 VR 콘텐츠, 가상현실 콘텐츠로 만드는 프로젝트 이름입니다. K-View 프로젝트가 한국에서 단순히 경험되는 콘텐츠가 아니라 해외에서 한국을 알고자 하는 K-POP 이후에 한국의 문화를 더 깊이 있게 알고자 하는 수많은 관람자들에게 의미 있는 콘텐츠로서 역할할 수 있다라고 판단을 하고 있습니다.
Gordon Media received a strong positive reception for its VR hanbok fashion show presented at the KCON event in France last June. The traditional culture industry accounts for 30% of the overall culture industry, but due to deficiencies in quality and practicality, it has yet to generate high added value. Convergence with science and technology is being hailed as a way to overcome these limits.
전통 문화를 지금까지는 보존에만 신경을 썼지만 앞으로 활용에 좀 더 관심을 가지고 다양한 분야의 전통 문화를 활용을 하고 또 전통 문화의 다양한 그 기술들을 접목을 시켜서 실생활에서도 쓸 수 있는 그런 현대적인 전통 문화를 많이 만든다고 하면 그 시장 가치는 지금보다도 훨씬 커질 거라고 생각이 되고 미래에는 그 잠재력이 무한하다고 보겠습니다.
In order to revolutionize the traditional culture industry, the Korean government announced a strategy for premium traditional culture creation through science and technology.
전통 문화에 대한 관심이 높지만 우리 일상과는 거리가 있고 K-POP 드라마와 같은 산업 측면의 한류 창출이 부족한 것이 현실입니다. 이에 전통 문화 자원에 내재된 가치를 일상생활에서 향유하고 산업화하기 위해 현대 과학기술의 융합을 본격적으로 추진하겠다는 것입니다. 더 나아가서 이제 세계인이 공감하고 함께 누릴 수 있는 계기를 만들 수 있을 것으로 저는 기대하고 있습니다.
In the past, Korea boasted excellent traditional steelworking technologies, procedures in which metal was folded thousands of times to create high-strength blades existed as far back as the 2nd and 3rd century. But the technique was all but lost during the Japanese colonial period. Research is underway to revive the technology to create high-end kitchen knives, high-strength metal materials and leisure goods.
이걸 자르면 이 잘린 면에 있는 속에 있는 불순물이 튀어나오죠. 접으면 인장 강도가 늘어나요. 왜냐하면 우리가 종이 한 장을 찍기 쉬워도 종이가 한 50장, 100장 되면 굉장히 어렵잖아요, 찍기가.
New materials are also being developed for a 3D printing architecture using traditional hanok building materials. The material, including pine wood, clay, and volcanic rock, boasts both eco-friendliness and high functionality. 3D printing architecture is on the rise globally, but the use of artificial materials is a problem. New markets can be pioneered by developing materials based on traditional natural resources like hanok materials.
일반적으로 전통 문화 자원은 환경 친화적이고 인간 친화적이고 그런 부분이 굉장히 많아요. 그런데 이제 현대 기술에 왔을 때 점점 화학 제품이 문제라든지 인공적으로 했던 것에 문제점이 많이 있는데 그것을 천연 자원이나 이런 것을 많이 사용을 한다면 우리 생활이 좀 더 안전하고 굉장히 좀 풍요로운 그런 문화의 향유나 이런 면도 가능하기 때문에 굉장히 중요한 분야라고 좀 생각을 합니다.
전통 자원을 새로운 과학 기술을 활용을 한다고 그러면 이것들을 소스로 활용을 해서 뭐 드라마라든가 콘텐츠를 만들 수도 있는 거고 또 이런 것들을 모티브로 해서 디자인을 또 할 수도 있는 거고 다양한 용도로 활용이 될 수가 있습니다. 따라서 이제 정부에서는 이에 대한 R&D 개발 자원을 좀 투입을 해야 되겠고 또 이거를 응용할 수 있는 그런 센터라든가 뭐 그런 어떤 인력이라든가 이런 것들도 구비하는 게 필요하다고 보겠습니다.
We look forward to the convergence of traditional cultural resources and modern science and technology becoming a new growth engine to lead the culture industry.
Organ donation is the practice by which a deceased individual chooses to donate healthy organs to patients who need them. September 9th is Organ Donation Day, an occasion for us to look back on the significance of organ donations and ask how more people can be encouraged to donate. Mr. Lee Sun-ho has had chronic glomerulonephritis since high school, suffering through regular kidney dialysis in order to survive.
투석을 월수금으로 4시간씩 해야 되니까요. 마음대로 어디 가지도 못하고 이제 또 그 자체가 너무 힘이 드니까 그게 제일 힘들었던 것 같습니다.
After a long wait, he was finally able to get a healthy kidney transplant this April. It was 22 years after his name had been entered into the waitlist for organ donation. He is currently recovering after surgery and says that organ donation has given him a whole new lease on life.
너무 큰 선물을 주셔서 제가 말로 이렇게 어떻게 표현해서 이걸 전달할 수는 없지만 너무 고맙습니다. 저희 식구들이나 제 가족들 모두가 정말 고마워하고 있습니다. 정말 주신 그 은혜라고 해야 될 정도인데요. 그 보답하기 위해서 열심히 노력하겠습니다.
The waitlist for organ transplants in Korea grows by 2,000 to 3,000 people each year. Last year, the list contained over 26,000 names. Unfortunately, there are far fewer organ donors, meaning that patients have to suffer a long time before finding a donor. In fact, 8% of patients pass away before receiving an organ transplant. Why aren't more people donating their organs?
만약에 저의 장기를 기증한다고 하면은 뭐 흔쾌히 뭐 기증할 의사는 있지만 만약에 저의 부모님이나 뭐 남동생의 장기를 기증하는데 동의를 해야 된다라거나 그런 상황이 온다면은 좀 꺼려질 것 같기도 하고
장기 기증을 일단은 해야 된다고 생각은 하는데 막상 뭐 우리 부모님이나 아니면 내가 실제로 내 장기를 누군가한테 잘 모르는 사람한테 준다는 건 일단 좀 거부감이 들어가지고
결국은 나와 내 가족을 위한 것이다. 그러니까 내가 기증을 하더라도 나중에 결국 나와 내 가족도 다른 사람으로부터 혜택을 받을 수 있다 생각이 들면은 그런 생각으로 기증을 하신다면은 나를 위한 기증 또 내 가족을 위한 기증이라고 생각하신다면은 훨씬 더 다른 인식을 할 수 있으시지 않을까.
Fortunately, the number of organ donors among the brain dead has been growing steadily, surpassing the 500 mark last year. The Korean Organ Donation Agency manages the procedure by which organs are donated from the brain dead. It operates a testing facility just for brain dead donors. In this system, necessary tests for brain dead organ donors are conducted around the clock and the results reported within 5 hours.
혹시라도 뇌파가 살아있을지를 대비해서 저희가 뇌파 검사를 시행을 합니다. 뇌파 검사에서는 30분간 평탄 뇌파가 나왔는지를 확인을 한 이후에 뇌에 정기적 자극이 아무것도 없다라고 판정이 되면 그 이후에 윤리적인 문제는 없는지 그리고 과연 이 사람이 뇌사로 장기 기증을 해도 되는 부분인지에 대해서 뇌사 판정 윤리위원회를 열게 되고요. 그 과정까지 모두 마친 이후에 뇌사를 판정을 한 이후에 또 기증을 하게 됩니다.
The Korea Organ Donation Agency also holds regular ceremonies to commemorate brain-dead organ donors and comfort their bereaved families. This allows the family members to feel pride in the organ donation and support each other throughout the healing process.
제 자녀가 살아있다는 느낌을 갖거든요. 누군가 내 딸의 심장을 가지고 누군가 내 딸의 심장을 가지고 산다고 하면 내 자식은 살아있다는 느낌, 죽었다는 의미 안 들어요.
가장 중요한 것은 우리 딸이 생전에 자기가 장기 기증을 하겠다는 그런 지나가는 말로 의사 표현을 한 것을 우리 부부가 들었어요. 그래서 그 뜻을 존중해 주는 것이 가장 중요했고 그랬죠. 그러니까 그것을 생각할 때 그래도 굉장히 힘이 들어요. 힘이 드는데 그런 사전에 그런 것들이 정리정돈이 돼 있었기 때문에 가능했다 봐야죠.
Countries around the world have been trying many different ways to increase the number of organ donors. In the US, individuals can register to be organ donors from the age of 13. In the UK, people are asked whether they would like to register as organ donors when they apply for the driver's license test. In Korea, a mobile app has been created to provide an easy and convenient way for anyone to register as an organ donor. Related organizations are also holding campaigns to change public attitudes towards organ donation.
그동안 어떻게 보면은 장기 기증이라는 것이 사회에서 담론화가 안 되고 그저 특정인이 하는 일 중에 좋은 일 하나로만 취급이 되고 있었습니다. 이제는 이것이 좀 더 사회에 담론화가 되고 시민이라면 누구나 해야 되는 일로 그렇게 인식을 해야 될 것입니다. 사회적으로 이분들을 예우를 하고 이분들의 뜻을 기리는 그러한 곳들이 생기고 그걸 통해서 많은 교육이 이루어진다면은 이 사회에 좀 더 많은 선순환이 이루어지지 않을까 생각을 합니다.
Organ donation is a precious gift that can change a patient's fate from death to life. We look forward to the day when everyone partakes in this valuable act.